Thanks. DD-WRT, Client Mode Setup. This setup is not a wired connection, is a wireless connection between two routers only. The router that you are trying to connect to is the primary router. The router you are configuring is the client mode router. A router in client mode connects to another wireless access point, the host router. It uses its wireless connection as the WAN interface and shares the internet connection only to the LAN ports. It is not seen as an access point by laptops or other computers, and does not accept wireless connections from client devices. The main and secondary router are on separate subnets. Network address translation is used between the routers, and when port forwarding is needed, it must be configured at both routers. The router in client mode must use its own DHCP server to give out IP numbers, gateway and DNS server to the devices connected to its LAN ports. Now with the setup. Open a web browser and connect to your router. Type your username and password. And to a clean setup, go to Administration, Factory Defaults, and Restore to Factory Defaults. Now wait until he do his thing, and, 30 to 40 seconds later, connect again to the router by his default IP, 192.168.1.1. Choose a new username and password. Next go to, Wireless, Wireless Security. Now select the security mode and other key information that matches your primary router which you will be connecting. After you configured exactly the wireless security as the first router, click to save. Next go to, Basic Settings. On Wireless Mode, select Client. Choose the Wireless Network Mode. Give the same SSID from the primary router. Assign to the same wireless channel. As optional, set the correct acknowledge timing in meters. And save the changes. Next go to Setup, Basic Setup. On Connection Type, select DHCP. Choose a router name. In the Network Setup section, set the local IP address to the next subnet available. Your client subnet must differ from the primary router subnet. For example, if the primary router ends on 0.1, choose 1.1. As optional, set static DNS servers in the network address server settings. If your wide area network not provide them, or you want to use a different DNS. Next, change your time zone and DST to match where you are. Optional. Set a server IP name for in time setting section for network type protocol. It will use a hidden default server if you leave it blank. And save the changes. As optional, if you do not need to worry about security between the access point and client router, go to Security, Firewall, and disable the SPI firewall. Now save. And apply settings. Set your computer back to auto IP and auto DNS if you like. You will get a DHCP address from the router. The client router should connect to the access point within a minute or less. You may need to unplug the router for 20 seconds if the router doesn't reset. After you ensure that it does connect, you may configure any other settings, for example, Virtual Interface for Wireless Connection. Client Mode Setup Successful. Now if your first router have access to internet, you can return to this video and give a comment, a thumbs up and subscribe. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks.